Oh, they have gone and done it now. Leave it to robots to turn sweet, sexy, passionate human love into a cold, calculated breeding farm. Whether they need us for batteries like in The Matrix, or they just want our sweet, fertile wombs so they can breed more Cylons like in Battlestar Galactica, I think popular science fiction has us convinced that some future supercomputer intelligence is going to spend all of its ones and zeros figuring out our birds and our bees. Ooh, not my birds and my bees. My birds and my bees are right here. Yeah. But what if the future is now? What if computers are already breeding humans? Hello, world. Welcome to CompChomp, the only show on the internets where it is technically impossible to overanalyze robot love. Love and machines have been going together for quite a while now. Aw, you guys, together. They go together. Now, computer-assisted dating goes all the way back to 1965. There was a lonely Harvard graduate named Jeff Tarr, and he blamed his inability to find a date on the limited dating pool. He wanted to do something about it, so he sent questionnaires out all over town to all the students in Boston, asking them about their ideal date. They filled out the questions, sent it in, he put it on punch cards because that is how you programmed in 1965. They fed those punch cards into the computer and out popped a list of six people guaranteed to be your ideal date. They called it Operation Match. This is very militaristic there. Operation Match, guaranteed to find you true love or freedom, America. Obviously, computer-assisted dating isn't just for the nerds of Harvard anymore. Stats alert! Woo, 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 woo! Woo, 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 woo! Stats alert! You know these are gonna be good stats when I put on my stats glasses and pull out my phone with information because I do not remember these. 22% of 18 to 24 year olds have tried an online dating app. 35% of recent marriages began in relationships that started online, and $1.7 billion is the amount of dollars spent on online dating every year. That is billion with a B. Speaking of B, this is blank. There's nothing on this phone. It's a prop, you guys. It's a good phone though. The level of machine matchmaking involvement varies depending on the site you've chosen. Choose eHarmony, and you're going to fill out a questionnaire of 200 questions, allowing them to rank you in six categories. If you go with Tinder, on the other hand, you're going to be doing a lot of this, or this, tinderizing. We're going to go with tinderizing. If you're tinderizing, on the other hand, Tinder decides who you see based on data points matching things like careers, education, and occupation, as well as more technical things like how many times you swipe right or left on someone who is similar to other people that they want to match you with. Similar to people that are similar to people. All people are similar to people. Blah. Xbox Live, on the other hand, matches you up based on the games you like to play and how good you are at playing them. Oh, what's that? I saw a little bit of an eyebrow raise there. You don't think Xbox Live works here? Well, perhaps you didn't realize that 50% of those marriages I mentioned earlier started from online dating sites, while the remaining 50% were from other places. People are meeting each other on the email, the Facebook, and even, yes, playing the online games. The one stat we weren't able to find, and trust me, I tried to have Josh find it, is the number of wow babies that are out there. But between you and me, if you meet a kid named Azeroth, we both know what happened. So how is it programmers are turning finding true love into a logical nerd fest? They're actually using the same kind of matching people up by preferences that we use in other areas of our lives. One great example of this is actually gonna help us binge watch 7 seasons of Friends this weekend. I'm not even kidding about that. Hashtag Friends Fest. You could tweet at me like, oh no, Joey didn't. Oh yes, Chandler did. Hashtag Friends Fest. Hashtag hashtags are lame. Good old Netflix. Stats glasses off, these shouldn't have been on this long. These aren't even my glasses. I'm a nerd with good eyesight. Back in the day, early Netflix built their business around recommending movies to their customers, and the success of their business depended upon how good those recommendations are. Because you and I both know how annoying it is when Netflix keeps telling you to watch Dora the Explorer. No, Netflix, I don't want to watch Dora. I don't. I've told you a million times I don't want to watch Dora the Explorer. I did. I told them. I keep recommending it. In 2007, they offered a $1 million prize to the man, woman, child, or team who dared to teach those Netflix computers a thing or two about recommending movies. That prize was claimed by one Mr. Gavin Potter. Josh, did we figure out if he was British or not? My name is so British. Lord Gavin Potter to see you now. It's because of Harry Potter, I don't know. He programmed the computers to learn from a combination of past behavior and group filtering. And you guys, this group filtering is such a cool thing. And the way it works is that the computer doesn't have to know any personal stuff about you. It just needs to know your preferences. If you love The Nightmare Before Christmas and you binge watch Friends all the time, then based on that, it knows that you will love Dora the Explorer. Okay, fine, I gave it a shot. It actually wasn't that bad. I kind of liked it. You win again, Netflix. Machine learning. It's actually kind of funny. Netflix was putting more money and effort into improving their recommendations for movies than a lot of dating sites were putting into the recommendations they make for true love. And that didn't escape the notice of some dating sites. A couple of sites in the UK actually approached Gavin Potter after he won, and they were like, "Yo, dude, can we use your code for our sites?" And he was all, "Okay." And now, you can have dinner and a date brought to you by the same lines of code. I wonder which one's gonna turn out better. Probably the date. No, the movie. And machines aren't just giving us romance in bulk. They're actually helping one nerd up his game in a very customized way. This guy built his own Tinder Automator to automate all of his Tinderizing. He built it using a facial recognition algorithm known as Eigenfaces.
Eigenfaces.
And the way it works is he swipes right on a couple pictures and the algorithm learns which faces he likes. It kind of seems a bit lazy to me. Like, this is not that hard, you guys. I don't know, if you want that automation in your own life, he open sourced the code and you can go onto GitHub and you can get it for yourself. So you see that machines are indeed choosing who you see and why, but it goes deeper. Who writes this stuff? Let's talk about your good friend, Tony. Tony and you have been friends for years, and you never really noticed him being all that funny, but lately his humor has just been on point. He posts these amazing cat gifs and these hilarious jokes, and he's always talking about his mom, and you've suddenly realized that Tony is totes adorbs. Now you're walking down that aisle and you're looking into Tony's eyes with true love, and you think it's all because you discovered his magical natural charisma. But the truth is that you should be sending a thank you bottle of sparkling apple cider to Mark Zuckerberg, or at least the Facebook dev team. And they probably don't want sparkling apple cider, but that's what I like, so that's what they're getting. Because Facebook, like other popular social networking sites, uses machine learning to decide which posts you like and only shows you those posts. Machines really are breeding humans then! Run for the hills! Delete those apps! Date your cousins! No! Don't date your cousins! That would be ridiculous. If you get one thing from this video, it should be not to date your cousins. But if you get two things, it should be that there's nothing to worry about with machine learning. Computers have a long and proud tradition of beating us at our own games. First, they crushed us in chess. Then they started dominating in Jeopardy, and now, the dating game. So what do you guys think? Is it creepy or cool that code plays such a huge role in human relationships? I'm kind of relieved that I don't have to worry about being part of some AI super plot because I met my husband offline the old-fashioned way. It's actually this really sweet story. We met our freshman year of college in a dorm that we were assigned to by a computer. CompChomp.